When you design a product or machine, it's absolutely critical that you consider the trade-off between the engineering development costs and the bill of materials costs that are going to go into that product. For low volume designs, it's pretty clear that you want to use off-the-shelf components and minimize your NRE cost. But for high volume, the situation can change. Adding a dollar to a product really adds up quick when you make a million units. That pays for a lot of engineering time. So there's several things you want to think about when you're designing for high volume systems, especially high volume mechatronic systems. First, you need to use the proper technologies. For the mechanics, that means things like injection molded plastic and sheet metal. For the electronics, you want to be sure to leverage as many components that are used in high volume things like the cell phone industry. And then you want to use cheap motors like DC motors. You also need to consider balance across the mechatronic system design. Everything from the power supply to the load needs to be carefully designed to work together so you don't leave excess margin on the table. Excess margin means excess cost. Finally, you want to look for opportunities to use clever algorithms to help you save cost. I call this trading atoms for bits. If you can take parts out of your design by doing something smart with the algorithms, you're going to save yourself significant cost. Those trade-offs can be hard to make, but if you understand your system well, you can find opportunities for significant cost reduction. To find out more about mechatronics and high-volume systems, visit us at simplexitypd.com.